is a presentation of Fox Sports.
We are Fox Sports. We are Ohio.
Just a few sleeps till Christmas, and the Jackets hit Music City, shopping for an early holiday win. Nashville, Columbus, live and only on Fox Sports Ohio. Coming to you tonight from Bridgestone Arena in the Music City. Now, the last time the Blue Jackets were here, they left on a high note. But can they do it again? Well, tis the season for family and friends, and hopefully the Blue Jackets will make a statement to ring out 2011. Good evening, I'm Natalie Taylor, and in order to make a statement, well, it's going to be difficult to say the least, because the Blue Jackets are in a tough stretch to finish out 2011. In fact, tonight, not going to be an easy beat by any means, taking on the Nashville Predators. And then moving on, we've got Chicago the day after Christmas. Calgary Flames come to Nationwide Arena, followed by Dallas. And finally, to end the season on New Year's Eve, there's the Washington Capitals. But before the team starts looking ahead, Jackets trying to win back-to-back games here at Bridgestone Arena. And now, as athletes would say, hey, we're taking a game a day-to-day basis. But you CBJ fans out there, you probably remember that the last time the Jackets were here getting that win, first win in 17 games for the Jackets here in Nashville. So will they be able to do it tonight? It is always a battle. And like Coach Arneal said today, this tends to bring out the best of both teams. And speaking of the best, let's go ahead and send it to the two best guys in the booth. How about some Jeff Rimmer and Bill Davidge? Good evening, guys.
And good evening to you, Natalie. Good evening, everybody. Happy holidays, everybody. Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. And the Jackets hope to take a Christmas break after another victory here in Nashville. They ended 5 years, Bill, of futility. Last visit in here, a thrilling overtime win with James Wisniewski scoring the game winner.
Yeah, and it got started right away. And how about this goal by Carter? Nice wrist shot, an even strength goal. And then Vinny Prospal on the power play. The Jackets were 2 for 5 on the power play on this given night. This a power play as well. Nice back pass by Johansson to be able to feed Umberger. And then, well, that finished it off. 2:17 in overtime. What a shot by Wisniewski. His only goal of the year.
And the next meeting was back in Columbus at Nationwide Arena. The Jackets played 58 solid minutes of hockey. But it was Nashville scoring twice in the final 2 minutes and then winning it in overtime. And they were led that night and have been led all season long by their team captain, Shea Weber.
Well, you know what? The second round pick back in 03. And right now he's on a modest 3-game point streak. For the last 6 years, he's been able to put up the points. In fact, 40 points in those given years. He is one guy that can shoot the puck. He creates the offense off of that shot. They had a chance to see that at Nationwide Arena, not once, but twice on that night.
And that was December the 8th. And up front, Martin Erat, another big night against the Blue Jackets. He sets up both the tying and game-winning goals. And Erat, almost a point per game in 51 career games against the Jackets, a total of 49 points, Bill.
Seventh round pick back in 99, if you can imagine. And you can take a look at the numbers that he's put up. Quick, he's got the hands. He has the ability to not only score, but also create it. And he got an assist on that game-winning goal in Columbus. Got to keep him in check, Jeff.
That win started a 5-game winning streak for the Nashville Predators. It ended Tuesday night in Washington against the Capitals. Let's go downstairs once more, and here's Natalie.
Hey, guys, it is going to be a tough one now. You can tell the crowd is starting to get into it as their team gets ready to take, but it's going to be a great atmosphere. Tonight we've got Curtis Sanford between the pipes for Columbus, and we also have Pekka Rinne. And you know what? As of late, he has had Columbus's number. He's won 11 against the Blue Jackets. Hopefully going to be a different case, but this game is always good between these two division rivals. Puck drop is coming up, so stay with us. We will be right back.
Bridgestone Arena in Nashville, Tennessee. The Jackets and the Predators renew their Central Division rivalry. Curtis Sanford making 27 stops and the Jackets 4-3 overtime win here back in November. And at the opposite end, Pekka Rinne, who Monday was named the second star of the week in the NHL, he went 3-0 with a 9.57 goals against average the previous week. Wes McCauley, Greg Kimmerly, the referees, David Lazarowicz and Mark Tkachuk are the linesmen. Jackets wearing their road whites and the Predators in their home jerseys as we get set before a crowd that's close to capacity here in Nashville. And Leg One wins the opening draw. Tonight's telecast brought to you in high definition by Time Warner Cable. Leg One backhands deep into Jackets territory, played by Tootin, looking up the wall, picked off there by Martin Erath. Jackets get it right back, and it's Dorsett. A backhand pass, my apologies, that is Lutescu, and it's sent into the zone. Chip to the corner, and on to Francois Bouillon. Lutescu pressuring. On here to John Blum. Picked up along the right wing, and the Jackets on the turnover. Vermette throws it into the zone, and the Predators get it right back.
How many times have we had a chance to watch Vermette do that? His first shift of the game, always trying to dish it off. They've got to get that mentality right away, Jeff. Shoot the puck.
On the right wing, Jackets look for Dorsett. Hops over his stick, backing up and controlling the puck here is Hillen. A centering feed. Brent Klitson, the healthy scratch, last time out in St. Louis, back in the lineup here tonight. And while we get a whistle early, there's Scott Arneal, and how about tonight's Toyota Keys, brought to you by your Central Ohio Toyota dealer.
Well, throw a log on the fires. You know, sparks are going to be going everywhere. What the Jackets need to do, add a little substance to that fire. In other words, get some structure in their game. Don't sit back and watch. It should not be cozy, a comfortable night. Work for everything you get for 60 minutes, and the best must be the best. That means Wisniewski, Nash, Carter, Sanford, they have to lead the way tonight.
Here's Mathot in front for Umberger, and Rinne down, and he will hold on. Pekka Rinne given the night off in Washington in that 4-1 loss at D.C., but he's back between the pipes tonight.
Well, the Jackets, again, win the draw in that zone, and when you move that puck back high again, then you get the traffic down in front of the net, and that's where you're going to find number 18 all night long in there trying to support. He's on a modest two-game point streak right now with a goal and a couple assists. Like to be able to add to that early.
Rinne has backstopped his hockey club to five straight victories. They've won four in a row on home ice. Vermette lets it go behind the net. It's played by Weber, rimmed around the wall and out of the zone. Hustling back, James Wisniewski. Wisniewski given a couple of days off in Columbus. Maintenance days after taking an awkward spill up against the wall in St. Louis. And he pronounced himself ready to go here this morning after the skate and anxious to get back and get the Jackets into the win column here after Wisniewski's overtime game winner last time out here in Nashville. A clearing pass goes off the stick of Rick Nash. It's played by the Jackets, John Moore. On to Klitson. Klitson for Nash with Umberger and Brassard. The three scoop deep into the zone. Save, big rebound given up by Rinne. And it's swept down and into neutral ice by the Predators. 2 minutes plus got. Off the stick there of Brassard. He'll edge it off into the corner. Walks around Shea Weber. It's moved off the wall and out. Suter sends to the Jackets line. Here comes Columbus again. Across the line looking for Umberger late in the shift. Umberger away from Suter. RJ Umberger spins, turns. Puck picked off by the Predators and away they go. Suter, right wing feed. Suter also picking up a couple of assists in that last meeting December the 8th in the overtime win. In fact, the last two games have gone to overtime. 9 of the 18. Overtime or a shootout as Sanford gets tested there and turns it aside. Away goes Jared Bull. Bull crossing the line offside. Ryan Johansson unable to hold the line. Let's get one more look here at that stop from in tight by Sanford.
Well, I know Sanford would like to be able to feel that puck early, but this one are in and around the net. You have a chance to watch Leg One sticking his nose, trying to get something to come off of that net itself. But Sanford back in the net. Back spasms are gone. He says he feels great and looking forward to starting tonight.
Jeff Carter wins the draw cleanly. It's Mark Mathot sending it cross ice and Wisniewski will hammer it in. Takes a wicked bounce off the stanchion. Jackets hustle to the puck. Kostitsyn scored that game-tying goal in Columbus the 8th of December. John Blum, who missed that game, throws it cross ice for Mike Fisher, who had a solid night in Columbus, and here tried to feather a pass in front.
One thing you can look right now is the matchup, that Carter-Prospo line up against Blum on defense. That is going to be something that the Jackets want all night long.
Interesting that Shea Weber and Suter in Washington were split up for part of that game, but we notice here tonight against the Brassard line, they're going head-to-head, Nash Brassard and R.J. Umberger. As you get a look at head coach Barry Trotz, who was not at all pleased with his club's performance in Washington that saw a five-game winning streak come to an end.
No, he wasn't very happy at all, but understandably so. This team right now has been playing some of its best hockey. He says our team right now is more of the identity that we want to have. It took a little time for us to get around and getting things together. We still have a long way to go in our improvement.
Coach Trotz telling us this morning this team is still a work in progress. Behind the net, Leguan gets it free. Greg Smith, a former Wisconsin standout, who leaves early to join this hockey club. He doesn't look out of place at all, Bill.
Well, he really doesn't. He started the year off right away, Jeff, and right now, well, he's in the top two in scoring, 24 points, and a young man that's given up a couple of goals this year as well. Down in front of the net, fires one up over top of the crossbar in an empty net.
We're going to keep an eye here on R.J. Umberger because he awkwardly went into Shea Weber here as Sanford makes the save, flexing that left leg. They hit leg on leg, and Umberger still flexing that left leg as he heads back to the bench.
Well, with vanishing deductible from Nationwide Insurance, you could save $100 off your deductible for every year of safe driving. To learn more, call our Nationwide Insurance agent of the game, Bob Rowland, in Powell, Ohio at 614-789-1891. Or visit nationwide.com to find a local Nationwide agent near you. Nationwide is on our side.
Spalling toss from the circle. Wilson stepped in and Sammy Paulson won the draw. Hillen with a shot, gloved by Sanford right there on the edge of the goal crease. He saw it through all that traffic and wisely held on as a couple of the Predators, including Tutu, were right there on the doorstep.
Well, that puck goes right back out to Jack Hillen, the product out of Colorado College. 4 years, and this guy offensively can produce some numbers. And right there, you can take a look at Sanford. Does a nice job. Top of the crease, good quick glove.
Off the draw. Going behind the net. Paulson with the steal keeps it away from Tutu, who pressures. Colin Wilson, who had that game winner in Columbus on the 8th of December. He was off to somewhat of a slow start. In fact, early on in the season, Colin Wilson was a healthy scratch. Former first-round pick of this Predators hockey club.
He's played well here in the last 9 games, Jeff. He's got 3 goals, 4 assists, and really the only bright spot offensively.
Dorsett tried to chip it out of the zone. Pressure coming. He'll get a second chance as that rolling puck comes right back to him. And this time Dorsett just deposits it deep in Nashville territory. 5.5 minutes gone here in the opening period. And a warm hello to those taking part in tonight's Blue Jackets viewing party at the R Bar. Thanks for tuning in. And happy holidays. Puck picked up. On the turnover, Smithson, the BC native, dumps it off. Halaschuk pressuring. Smithson able to edge it free, but it's Mark Mathot. The outlet pass getting away from Derek McKenzie. Big McGrattan, we thought would be a healthy scratch, taking some extra skating here this morning, Bill, but he's playing as opposed to Blake Jeffrey on tonight.
Yeah, he spent about another 20 minutes on the ice, working on his shot, doing a little extra skating. You're right, as Jeffrey on sits in the press box.
We'll step aside, a scoreless first period. Predators with a one-shot advantage, 4-3, with 13:48 left in the first. The rest of the Nashville Predators on the right, David Poile, the only general manager this franchise has had. On his left, his assistant, former NHLer, Paul Fenton. And if we just kind of pan out there, that is Brent Peterson, the former associate coach, and a great story to tell about Brent Peterson, who had to step down because of Parkinson's disease. He underwent a lengthy surgery and surgical procedure that went in 4 different stages. You want to talk about Christmas time and feel good stories, Brent Peterson's going to join me here in our first intermission. You want to stay tuned for that.
And it really is special, people, and I would urge you to stay tuned.
There's Tootin. Puck picked up. Mike Fisher. Fisher with a shot that's deflected wide of the net. Christensen unable to play it. As the net is dislodged, play is called. And we'll get a face-off.
Well, right now on FoxSportsOhio.com, get the latest from the columnists and the Buckeyes' battle with the Miami Redhawks on the hardwood, and see the video for UC's prep for the Liberty Bowl. It's all on FoxSportsOhio.com, presented by 1-800-SAFE-AUTO and SafeAuto.com. Well, the nice thing today is the Nets being able to just basically be knocked off their moorings. You go back 20 years ago, the Nets, they were stable, and how many injuries did we have at that time? Not only by the running into the post, but also the formation of the net itself with that metal pipe through the middle of the bottom of the rink. It was unbelievable, the number of players that were basically hurt through that area itself.
Vermette walks out of the corner. On to Moore. Puck gets away from Dorsett. Rene unable to play it. Jackets from the right point in front. Paulson ripped it wide. Vermette off escape. Predators unable to clear. There's Vermette. Sends to Dorsett. Dorsett with a shot that's deflected wide. Dorsett gets it off the backboard. Good hustle. In front, Sammy Paulson. Predators come up with the puck, and it's moved out of the zone as Fisher tried to send it ahead. Teams change up here on the fly. As we approach the 8-minute mark. 7.5 minutes plus gone. Predators through the neutral zone. A lead pass there for Smith, broken up. Off a stick. Away from Leguan. Here's Nash. Nash now had it knocked away. Thrown back. Mark Mathot. Mathot. On to Rick Nash. Nash through the neutral zone. Nash now crossing the line. Great poke check there by the Predators. They control in their own zone as Erat dishes it back. Jay Weber, long lead pass, just missing Smith. It'll be played by Wisniewski. And James Wisniewski hands it off to Mark Mathot. Jackets change up on the fly. Back to Wisniewski. And away from Haluschuk. Off Derek McKenzie. Rene out to play it. Pekka-Rinne pressured there. Jackets can't come up with the puck as Rene now in a bit of an adventure. Gets the goal stick from his defenseman. And maintains his position deep in that Nashville net.
Rene had a night off in Washington the other night, Jeff, and right now he's also been given the chance not only to start tonight, but he'll also start tomorrow night in Dallas.
Puck thrown to the corner, walking out here. Ryan Johansson lost the stick, retrieves it. Johansson a healthy scratch in the last game. Back at center tonight, playing with McKenzie and Jared Bull. Weber. Able to sweep it away. Big McGrattan deals ahead here to Smithson. Klitsum steps into him. Loose puck picked up outside the line. Here's Vermette with a shot off the pad. The rebound followed up by Johansson, but the puck hopped over a stick.
Well, nice job by Vermette. That's the idea. You come down that wing, let the shot go. You get a little supporting cast coming to the blue of the crease.
Vermette. On to Nikitin. Tootin away from Kostitsyn. Dorsett. Dumps in. Rene will trap it behind the net. And the Predators, John Blum. California born, making it to the National Hockey League. Nikitin looks far side. Fisher will pick it up. Fisher turned around by Dorsett, who's able to steer it away. Paulson the backhand and on to Vinny Prospel. Prospel edges it off the wall, hustles after it. Bouillon defended. Prospel continues to pressure that puck. Here's Blum. Blum sends it off the wall. It's picked up by Hornqvist, stepping up and across into Jackets territory, but offside was Bouillon. 9:52 left. Opening period. Shots are even at four. We're scoreless. Martin Erat, who, as you mentioned previously, setting up the tying and winning goals back in Columbus earlier on this month, and needless to say, as we get a look at Romeo's Pizza, who's hot, Martin Erat, more points against the Jackets than any other team in the NHL.
Well, he's one player right now that is really struggling offensively. Yeah, he's getting the odd assist, but he scored one goal in the last 15 games. Barry Trotz said this morning, there's a few guys on this hockey team, they've got to be able to chip in a little bit more than what they've been doing here as of late.
Now, we're not talking about a high-scoring team in the name of the Predators, and you look who's assumed their points lead, and that's Shea Weber with 25. And of course, right behind, you talked about Craig Smith, the rookie, who's second in scoring on this team. Here's Jordan Tootoo. On to Colin Wilson. Moving in, Spalling denied. Rebound, turned aside once more by the Jackets netminder, Sanford. Predators get it back. Wilson tried to walk to the net. Jackets intercept. Kept in by Blum. Letestu out of any Prosper. And the Jackets will dump in. Prosper, seeing that his line mates are heading off, he too will join them back on the Columbus bench as we've all but hit the 11-minute mark of a scoreless first period. Leguan, Erat, left wing feed for Smith. Smith dumps behind the net. Leguan's on it. David Leguan, the original number one pick of this franchise in their expansion year. Moving in from a sharp angle, tossed in front for Erat, and Suter retreats to that right point. Ryan Suter, unrestricted free agent, and continues to be a topic here in Nashville. David Poile attempts to re-sign him. We're going to get the first power play with a holding penalty against the Jackets. And it's Nikita Nikitin who's headed to the box.
It's Wes McCauley.
Columbus minor penalty holding.
There's another college product out of Michigan State University. And watch Nikitin below that goal line trying to play man up. And you get a chance to watch Smith. Nikitin loses him just for a second. And with his size and his strength, Smith goes down, minor penalty. First power play of the night, Jeff.
11:30, the time of the holding penalty. And this Nashville Hockey Club, sixth in power play efficiency at 20.4%. A bit of a surprise, but then when you've got a couple of big shooters on the point, you can understand in Suter and Weber. Jackets on the penalty kill, 28 to 30. They have killed off the last 10 in a row. And they'll look to continue that here right now. Puck thrown up high, and it's Weber walking the line. On to Suter. Puck played along that far wall. Hornqvist waits in the slot. Kostitsyn. Hornqvist and the man with the puck, Fisher. Thrown back to the point for Suter. On to Weber. He's got the big, heavy shot. Weber gets it ahead. Kostitsyn moves it off into the corner. Hornqvist ridden off there by Tootin, whose defensive mate is in the box with the penalty for holding. Up high, cross ice, Kostitsyn fires, save, rebound, scores! Mike Fisher on the far side, left all alone after the initial stop, is able to sweep home the rebound, and it's a 1-0 Nashville lead.
Well, it's 10 power play goals in the last 10 games for the Nashville Predators, and boy, did they move the puck around well. Jackets were doing a nice job until all of a sudden when you see that puck come back and the good fake by Kostitsyn and then back door off the pad and you see Fisher right off the back door and you can see the shot and just basically that rebound coming directly to that weak side and Fisher finds Pater. That is a seventh of the year, a second power play goal. They have taken a 1-0 lead, 1-for-1 on their power play.
Puck played along the wall. Grant Clixon on to Prosper. This is Letestu. Had it poke checked away by David Leguan. Off Blum. Prosper hustles for it. Deep in the zone. Vinny Prosper. Away from Blum. Carter scores! Jackets come right back. Vinny Prosper circles the net. Finds Jeff Carter in the slot. And the quick shot ties it up just seconds later.
Well, and again, you take a look and you have a guy like Carter gets on the ice and he makes something happen. But he gets a little help from his winger. And look at the pressure by Prosper down below the goal line. And then he hears Carter from that slot area right from the circle itself. A good quick release right there by Carter. That's his eighth of the season. And what other teams have done to the Jackets in the last 10 games, the Jackets, it's payback right back after that power play goal of the Preds.
.1229, the time of the Fisher goal, and at .1256, the Jackets storm right back to tie it up. 1-1, but less than 7 minutes to go. Two goals in 26 seconds. And that's a good sign when the Jackets come right back after giving up the power play goal.
Especially in the opposing team's building, Jeff, it means that much more. You quiet the crowd, you keep them out of it.
Puck played here by Brassard. From the wing, the stop by Rene off the stick of Nash. Now Jeff Carter's got his young sister who just returned from Australia where she spent a year, and dad in attendance. This was the building that Jeff Carter was drafted in the first round by the Philadelphia Flyers, and dad always enjoys making the trip from London and coming back here to Nashville.
Yeah, they're going to hop on a plane right after the game and head back home for Christmas. For Carter, well, that comes at a great time. How about five goals now in the last seven games for Carter? And his shot, good quick release. He catches Rene before he gets a chance to really set up shop in that crease.
Eighth goal of the year for Carter. Prospel draws the lone assist. Vinny Prospel continues to lead the Jackets in scoring. That's his 20th assist and 27th point. 1-1 tie here. Little to choose from between these two teams through most of this first period. The Predators with a slight edge in shots at 7-6. And a 1-1 tie as the teams trade goals seconds apart. Puck sent off the wall. Backhanded. Here's Johansson. Dumps into the corner on a backhand. Bull in pursuit. Drilled behind the net. Bull continues to fight through. It's played by the Predators. Hillen throws it in front. That one goes off McGrattan and sent to neutral ice. Nikit finds Bull in the right wing. McGrattan drilling Bull from behind, and Jared's down. And if that's not a major for boarding, I don't know what is.
Well, that is certainly going to be
his
a major for
back
boarding.
Was to the play, and I'd like to see a replay and see if there is contact with the head.
Well, I think Brendan Shanahan is certainly, look at this. Oh boy. Bull had a chance to look over his shoulder, so he had a chance to know it was coming. But when McGrattan had a pretty good head of steam up, tell you what, Jared took the brunt of that right along the wall. And he still is down on his knees, being attended to by Mike Vogt.
I tell you, the two officials here, Kimberly and McCauley, are discussing over the penalty bench what exactly they're going to call here. They've not yet made the call. The discussion continues between the two referees. And Bull's getting up, and just now they are going to make their determination. Is it two or is it five? We'll let you know when we come back.
A lot of shots on Rennie.
Thanks for your time, Brad.
Thank you.
Well, they're going to get an opportunity to get a few more shots on Rennie. A five-minute major to Brian McGrattan. The Jackets have an opportunity right now to be able to hopefully get ahead and get themselves a lead.
Carter scores! Power play goal! And the power play will continue. Carter with a backhand over the sprawled Rene. It's a power play goal, and Carter's got his second of this opening period.
Well, for both hockey teams tonight, you get bounces. And if you get bounces and you're around the net, you're there to be able to collect it, and then you've got to find a way to deposit. The deflection, and you can see Nash, he had a chance on the backhand once, and right off of the skate of Suter, coming right back out to Carter. He gets it underneath that right pad of Pecorine, his second goal of the night. It's a 2-1 hockey game.
Fourth power play goal of the nine that he has now scored. And the Jackets have the lead, and with a five-minute major, they can continue on the power play and pretty well score here at will.
The Jackets right now, five power play goals in their last six games, and one of the main reasons, well, it is number seven. Been able to find a home around that net, and he's self-admittedly one of the streakiest players in the game. He says, when I score a lot, and they come in bunches.
Sanford's going to hold on with Leguan right there.
Carter is his fourth power play goal of the year. And Sanford gets an opportunity to be able to get back into the pipes.
From the draw. Puck kept in by Suter at the right point. Fetter Tootin, who picks up an assist here along with Rick Nash on that power play goal. Nash, the primary assist. Tootin picks up the second assist And he now has a three-game assist streak. That is his fifth assist in the last three games. He had three assists against the Blues on Sunday. And here, Rene is going to hold on with that shot coming from the wing.
Well, fans, see the Blue Jackets take on the Calgary Flames Tuesday, December the 27th at 7 o'clock with the Tim Hortons Jackets Pack. It includes a game ticket, $10 food and beverage voucher, a team hat and more, all for just $30. Plus, the first 15,000 fans are going to receive a Blue Jackets calendar presented by Subway. Get your tickets now at BlueJackets.com.
Spalding wins the draw away from the Jackets youngster, Johansson. Letestu at the point. Four of his five goals have been on the power play. Rene fought that one off. Again, he missed the Washington game and doesn't look too steady here. And look at the Jackets get a goal from Ryan Johansson. His first point in 11 games. Johansson left in front. And as I was just saying, Rene does not look sharp. Another power play goal, and it continues for another 3:56.
Well, Ryan Johansson will collect his sixth goal of the year. And the last time he scored, November the 12th, two goals against the Winnipeg Jets. And right there, he gets himself into that crease area. All started because of a little bit of a rebound that Rene gave up from the point. And a nice job there by Johansson on that second power play unit to give the Jackets a two-goal lead. 3-1 here in that first period.
And Carter comes back with Prospel and Nash. Jackets power play in a little over a minute of the McGrattan five-minute major for boarding. The Jackets have scored twice and are now on their third power play. Here's Carter. Throws it cross ice. Vinny Prospel. The Jackets have quieted the crowd here at Bridgestone Arena. Nikitin pressured there by Smithson. Tootin on the opposite side, fishes it free, and then Nikitin drives it deep. Carter on that right wing. Jackets 3, Predators 1. Columbus scoring their first goal 27 seconds after the lead, and there's another goal! The Jackets backhanded in! It's Jeff Carter with the hat trick, a natural hat trick! 3 goals in the first, 3 power play goals! And there's still 3 minutes and 12 seconds left on the McGrattan. Costly major penalty.
Well, it's the first time in franchise history I've had a chance, Jeff, to watch the Jackets perform like they have on a major penalty. 3 power play goals, you just mentioned it. But how about Carter again setting up shop? Rene, for the third time, unable to collect that rebound. It was in the glove. It's out of the glove. And then Carter kicks it up to himself on a little backhand, finds Paydirt. And a 4-1 game right now. The Jackets, as you mentioned, still have time on the clock.
Rene does not look anywhere near as competent as we have seen him in the past. He is just gift-wrapping those rebounds, and the Jackets are capitalizing. On the Johansson goal, Umberger and Brassard draw the assists. The Jackets have now scored 4 goals in less than 4 minutes. It all started with the equalizer. Carter's first of the three. He has 3, Johansson 1. 2:35 left in the major. 3 power play goals. They're now on the fourth on this five-minute major. A new power play comes up after each goal. And there's Letestu, Brassard. Wisniewski with a shot. Another rebound. Jackets fight for that loose puck. Letestu on to Brassard. Rim to the point. Brassard will pick it up. Throws it back here for Wisniewski. One-timer Letestu. And it's redirected off a stick wide. Spalling will bank it off the boards. 2.5 minutes left in the period. Less than 2, as you see, on the power play. Federtut carries off ice. The last goal, Carter from Nash and Nikitin. Haluschuk with the steal, sends it in on Sanford. 4-1, Columbus, if you've just joined us. 3 power play goals on the five-minute major. And Jeff Carter has his first hat trick as a Blue Jacket. And a natural hat trick here in the first period.
And there's a lot of hockey to be played.
And don't think
And the Predators will be reminded about that after the opening period.
I'd be surprised if Rennie will be starting period number two. I think Lundback will get the call.
There is Broussard, and he rifles it wide. Smithson pressured by Carter. Moved up, but not out. Letestu had it briefly. Puck sails out to center. And now Broussard right back to Letestu. Less than a minute left in the McGrattan Major. A right wing feed for R.J. Umberger. He takes Erat off into the corner. Erat fights through, and it's on to Suter. Suter chips it off the wall and sent in deep, where it'll be played by Sanford. And it's on to Wisniewski. James Wisniewski. Letestu. Mark Letestu. Antoine Vermette. Cross ice pass driven in by Wisniewski. Trapped behind the net by Rene, and then fired high and out. Less than a minute to go in the period. 22 seconds remain in the McGrattan Major.
The Jackets have been able to put 15 shots on goal here in period number one, 7 by the Preds.
And the Predators had a 7-6 edge. So up until that last sweeping stop by Sanford, it was all Columbus. 9 consecutive shots. 3 make it 4 consecutive goals. And now less than 30 seconds remain as Paulson steps into his man. Up along that left wing. Predators pressure the puck, but it's the Jackets that come up with it. Hornqvist had it briefly. 2-2 tried to deposit it far side. The Jackets able to collapse down low and sweep it out of the zone. Final 10. Long shot by Hornqvist, played by Sanford. And it's Nikitin lifting it high and out. And this will do it. The first period will come to an end. But the Jackets storm back after the Predators score a power play goal of their own. Jeff Carter with a hat trick. The Jackets score 3 power play goals and lead by 3 after 20 minutes of play. In Nashville, Broadway, downtown Nashville, not too far from the arena. How the story? Jeff Carter, 3 goals in that opening period, his first hat trick as a Blue Jacket. And I stand corrected. That is not a natural hat trick. A natural hat trick is 3 straight goals. And of course, Ryan Johansson ruined the natural hat trick.
Well, I said the same thing and forgot that Johansson had the one in between to start it all off.
So my apologies. And we'll take the hat trick. And we'll take the fact that that is a franchise record for the 3 fastest Columbus goals in a minute 36. Jackets, a 4-1 lead. And the puck fired in. It'll be played by 2-2 on the far side. Early in the second period. Jackets, Letestu with the steal. Puck thrown ahead, goes off a stick, and then swept into the zone. Blum off the wall. Stepping up here is Mark Mathot. Mathot hands it ahead. There's Prosper for Carter, and it's off the goalpost. He had Rene beat on the far side, looking for number 4. Puck sent off the wall, and the Jackets come again. Carter moves around Hornqvist and backhands it wide of the open corner. When you're in a zone, you're in a zone. And Carter's in one right now.
Well, right now, they've matched up against Bouillon as well as Hillen out there. And that's exactly what Scott Arneal wants. You can see it from the drop of the puck tonight. They tried to split Weber and Suter up. But when you've got 2 lines that are going, it's tough to play them both straight up.
Coach Arneal, after this morning's optional skate, was asked repeatedly about the Jackets' last victory here back in November. Talked in terms of the monkey off their back. Talked in terms of this black hole. A cloud that hung over the franchise playing here in 17 consecutive games. He said, hey, the boys should come in here tonight confident, knowing they could come up with a victory. And a solid first period, and they've come right back here in the second, continuing to carry the play. Up high, Nikitin drills it. That's off Pecorine's blocker and sent wide of the net. Nash on to Broussard. Derek Broussard threads the needle, clips him in front. And a goal mouth pass just missing the stick of Umberger. Jackets all around Nashville This is a carryover from the power play. The teams are at full strength.
Right now, Nashville just right back playing at their home base, allowing the Jackets right now to dictate that offensive zone.
Klitsam, Erat. Grant Klitsam on to Rick Nash. Nash walks off the wall. Nash drops it back for Brassard. Brassard drills it. Shot blocked by Fisher. Played by the Predators in the zone, and it's Erat circling. As Nashville change on the fly, Jackets get fresh legs on as well, and Erat will dump in and then race over to the bench. 3 minutes plus gone here in the second. Suter with a perfect feed. There's a shot. Big rebound, and it hops over the stick of Hlestchuk. Suter, left point. Blocked by Jared Bull. Bull's stick broke. Jackets break it up, and it's Derek McKenzie who chips it into the zone. It'll be played by Rene. And off into the corner for Weber. Shea Weber. Left there for Suter. Right back to Weber. Predators, big rangy defenseman across the line. Knocked off his stick. And the Jackets just, at this point, totally controlling this hockey game.
They are, but you know what? There's still a lot of time on the clock, Jeff. Let's not kid ourselves. You got basically 36 minutes. And if you remember going back to Nationwide Arena, they scored two goals in the last 2 minutes of play to take that game into overtime and made a quick remedy of it in overtime as Erat set up that game-winning goal.
Here's Francois Bouillon sending it to center. Erat had it broken up by Carter, swept ahead, and on the right wing, it's chipped by Vermette deep into the zone. Leg one. Keeps it away from Derek Dorsett. Predators march through the neutral zone, carried in and across the line. Here's a shot from the wing, right there, square to the shooter, and holding on is Carter. Carter wins the draw. Away from Mike Fisher, Jackets clear the zone. And play is called as we check out the IGS Energy performers from the opening period of play. Jeff Carter, his third career hat trick, four shots, and a total of 5 minutes and 43 seconds.
He's had a pretty good start to period number two as well. And let's take a look at as he comes in across that line, and he gets an opportunity and rings it right off of that stick side post. Rene over tried to overplay him, and then a good opportunity with a backhand as well.
Oh. This could be a career night for Carter. He continues at this pace. And it's Carter in pursuit.
Did we have a Red Berenson lead?
Want to talk about it?
Six goals, four assists. Knows a little bit about it. Both Sittler, same thing with the Toronto Maple Leafs. In fact, Sittler had the 6-4. Berenson had 6-3.
Backhanded, knocked down by Hornqvist. Hornqvist into the slot. Erat turned aside by the stick save. 5 minutes plus gone here. Second period. Predators. Erat. An arm around him from Brassard. And that's going to cost him a penalty. In front. There's Hornqvist. And a goal. On a delayed penalty. Rene made his way to the bench. He was not yet off the ice. The sixth skater wasn't out there. But it is Patrick Hornqvist with the goal. That will nullify the penalty, and it's 4-2.
Well, you can see him move the puck around, and Hornqvist had nothing but net. That is his second goal in 20 games for Hornqvist. He started the year off fine, and it really went into a drought, but right there, great puck movement. He finds himself all alone, and it's a 4-2 hockey game.
For Hornqvist, his ninth of the season. Jackets responded when the Predators were first on the board, the power play goal by Fisher. 27 seconds later, the Jackets came back. And boy, did they ever. A franchise record, three goals in a minute 39 separated them from the Predators here as we approach the midway point of the second period of the hockey game. Rene, left for Hillen. 5 minutes plus gone. Hillen dishes it off in the right wing. Jackets have got to guard Bill against sitting back here now. And not
letting these Predators back in the hockey game.
Well, that's exactly. You just got to continue to keep playing this hockey game. Still early, anything can happen. You've got to be able to come in here. And again, I go back to utilizing your four lines with a little bit of speed. Continue to take the body against this hockey team. That's when you have your success.
Weber draws the first assist, adding to his points lead. That is point number 26 for Weber. Leguan with an assist as well. The Predators are on the prowl again here. 2-2, trying to keep it away from Dorsett. Late on that right wing. Center, shot, save, rebound. Play whistle down. As it was deflected, it went off the netting. And that quick shot sent wide of the net on the deflection. But Hornqvist has the Predators back to within two.
Spalling on the right. And these two young guys played for Kitchener in the Ontario Hockey League, two premier junior players. And at this time of the year back in Canada and throughout the World Junior Championships are something to behold. These two young men were invited to camp, and at that time, well, Spalling fell ill. In fact, he had felt ill a couple of weeks prior to that camp taking place. They find out he had mononucleosis, unable to play, and they went on, and that year was able to win that gold medal for Canada.
Predators behind the net, Erat. Martin Erat looks to walk out. Erat, top of the circle, sends it in front. Shot by Erat for the left wing boards, played off the wall there. Predators with the pressure on here. Leguan steers free. Erat, Smith, Jackets able to steal. They chip it off the glass, the zone not cleared. Smith throws it back in front. Jackets defend. There's a penalty upcoming here. Leguan's going to go off here for hooking or tripping. The crowd upset. Sanford makes his way out of the net. The Leguan stick got caught in between the skates of the Jackets defenseman. And a tripping penalty here will put the Jackets on the power play for the fifth time tonight. Incidentally, the Jackets hadn't scored a power play.
11 Nashville minor penalty tripping.
Had not scored three power play goals in a game. They scored three on that 5-minute major. And watch this tripping call here.
Well, a couple of boys from Michigan. You see Leguan with a stick inside. Wisniewski tried to make his move up ice. So the Jackets will get an opportunity to go on their power play. A 5-minute major to McGrath in period number one. And now the second overall power play here in period number two.
Puck thrown into the slot. Brassard off Rene. And it's Nikitin dealing it for R.J. Umberger. Puck sent off the wall and down. Here, the puck played ahead. And it's Brassard feathering a pass to R.J. Umberger. In front, Johansson, and a goal! I believe it went off Ryan Johansson. That'll be his second of the night. The Jackets' fourth power play goal of the night in five power play chances. Umberger thread the needle, threw it in front. I think it went off Johansson. We'll get another look at it here.
Well, a nice play by Brassard coming across the line, just basically being patient. And then you have Johansson as he drives to the net. Umberger, he just tries to force that blue, and all of a sudden that puck comes available, and Johansson just gets a piece of it. Now, did it hit his skate, or was he able to get it back up to his stick? In fact, I don't think he touched it at all, Jeff. Yeah. I think Umberger will get credit for that goal.
Well, we'll wait for it officially. But it may, in fact, have gone in off Suter. That's why I said I did not know for sure, for certain, if, in fact, Johansson got a stick on it.
What a great play by Brassard. Coming across the line, just basically holding up, being patient. And the Jackets had another power play on the total tonight.
4-4-5. There's Dorsett. Paulson looks to cycle out. Dorsett trying to dance away from Hillett. Columbus 5, the Predators 2. And we have yet to reach the midway point of the second period in the hockey game. Paulson on to Dorsett. We've got one more look And a replay that could very well be the definitive replay. We get an opportunity, we'll show it to you. Johansson right now being credited with the goal. A centering pass goes off the side of the net. Another penalty upcoming. Out of the net, there's a goal. The second time in this period, a delayed penalty will go for naught. And the Predators are right back. It's 5-3.
Yeah, there was going to be that minor penalty being called. And it is going to be Nick Spaulding who finds himself down in front of the net. I'll tell you what, things are opening up in this hockey game. You have a chance to watch Spaulding there, or Wilson grab a hold of the puck. You can see the check right now from behind. And as Spaulding finds his position down in front of the net, a beautiful pass, tape to tape to the forehand. Samford, there's not a whole lot he can do. You just hope that maybe Wisniewski can get a stick on it. Spaulding finds the back of the net to make this a 5-3 hockey game.
And from the faceoff, these 8 goals, not the norm between these two teams. They play close games, as I mentioned earlier on in the telecast. 9 of the last 18 have gone either to overtime or a shootout. You got to look at Barry Trotz and Scott Arneal on the other side.
No talking to Troncy in that game back in Columbus. Well, they needed to put a little heat on the net and stay focused, and that's exactly what they did in being able to come back with less than 2 minutes to go to tie it. And he kept telling his team that it's never over. It is never over. He's living proof again here tonight.
Nick Spaulding cutting the deficit to 2. Assisted by Wilson and Tutu. The goal at 8:53 makes this one a 2-goal hockey game. Predators throw it up the right wing boards. Carter able to break that up. Now Prosper will send it high and up onto the Columbus bench, and there's no further play.
You know, right now both teams, both benches, have just got to settle things down right now. And you can see Umberger arguing with the linesman, and I don't know what he was arguing about. Anyway, you look at it, it was chipped out. Faceoff should take place just opposite of that Nashville bench. Right now, Barry Trotz trying to calm his bench down. You got to take it shift by shift right now. Jackets, yes, they've got 5 on the board. They've got to continue to play their hockey, be cognizant, watch your matchups, and that's also a key tonight with both hockey teams.
R.J. Umberger on the left wing. He's got Broussard and Nash with him. Puck fired in, Hornqvist getting an arm around the Jackets' alternate captain, R.J. Umberger, who tried to get a stick on it there. Hornqvist right there shadowing the Jackets' winger. Just past the 10-minute mark of the second, a right-wing feed for Nash. Nash threw it across the line, sends it away from Suter. And the matchup that Barry Trotz has preferred all night long is the Weber-Suter defensive pairing, who came in tonight a plus 25 combined. And when Broussard, Umberger, and Nash are out there, those two have been the defensive pair. Puck carried in and across the line. There's a backhand pass right across the goal mouth. It'll be played up high by Derek McKenzie, who leads the Jackets in a plus 7. He'll send it on. Rene will hold on. There's 9:23 left. A wild and woolly affair. Giving in the holiday season. 5-3.
Blue Jackets with a 5-goal lead over the Predators with 3 here on Predators home ice. I'm now joined by Todd Richards. Todd, 4 power play goals out of 5 attempts. What is clicking on the power play tonight?
Well, we're shooting the puck and we're creating a lot of traffic in front of Rene, creating some scrambles, and we're getting some bounces, but we're also working for the bounces.
Thank you for your time.
And that's the one thing. They've basically forced Rene to play the puck. Given up a couple of rebounds, and the Jackets, they basically overloaded in front of the net and have taken advantage.
Johansson, who went 10 games without recording a point, has a pair of goals credited to him here tonight. 5-3, and now we're seeing more of the Predators going to the body here. Didn't see a lot of hits earlier on in this hockey game. One that was costly was the one by McGrattan. Cost him a 5-minute major if you've joined us late. And the Jackets scored almost at will. And yet, Another penalty here. This one for slashing.
Columbus penalty number 24, 2 minutes, slashing.
Well, I think that the Nashville fans thought it was going to go towards the Nashville Predators. And in fact, it will be Derek McKenzie making his way to the penalty box. He'll have an opportunity to go on the power play. This is where now, in a 5-3 hockey game, your goaltender has to be able to stand out.
So, there were two previous penalties that were going to be called against the Blue Jackets. This one is a wild and woolly affair. Two previous were going to be called, and on delay of the penalties, the Predators cashed in with a couple of goals. And now, they get their second power play, officially. They're one for one, and they move to the point. Suter, on to Weber. Puck thrown to the point, and out. As it's swept down the ice.
Now their power play is simple. You get it back to the point, and you have Suter as the playmaker, and they set Weber up for the one-timer, and then you better overload down in front of the net, because they will cover all three areas with their forwards and outman them 3-2.
Rolling puck on in. Puts him behind the net, defending against a couple of the Predators there. Wilson will rim it around. This is Weber, on to Suter. Suter. Half board thrown behind the net there by Smith on the leg one. Mathot defended. Up high, Weber. Watch the line. Leg one. This crowd is in it here right now. A pass for Smith. Leg one will tip it back. Suter. One-timer. The right-handed shot on the left point. And Sanford's able to turn that one aside. Puck thrown to Weber again. Weber for Suter. Settles it down. Suter. Half board. Leg one. Backing him up. Suter. Into Smith, Jackets defend. Umberger trying to get a stick on it. Jackets do, and it's Mathot who lifts it high and out. You see the time remaining, down to 18 seconds.
And a nice job by Umberger. You drop down into that box, into that slot area. We're not going to feed the point. We'll try to feed that forward who finds that quiet area.
Here comes Kostitsyn across the line. Kostitsyn deals it ahead. He'll get it back. 2 seconds remain in the McKenzie penalty. Puck in the slot, hops over the stick of Fisher. McKenzie's out. And went into the offensive blue line. Dorsett will carry in. Onto the wing. There's a shot high and wide by Sammy Paulson. Puck played by the Predators. Bouillon sends it off the wall. That's center. Picking up and crossing the line there is Martin Erat. Edged ahead by the Jackets, but not out. Bouillon steps up. Shot from the right point and a goal. Oh, what a blast. It's a one-goal hockey game.
You said it, Jeff. That didn't take long to get to the back of the net. And that's the one thing that the Nashville Predators like to be able to do. They will stretch out that offensive zone. And again, a D to D, and you load it up with a one-timer. And I'll tell you what, caught everything on that one. I believe Josi is the one that got that. Bouillon makes the pass. And Josi, top of the circles, and boy, I'll tell you what, he beat Sanford high on that glove side, and that was behind him before Sanford even had a chance to make a move.
James Wisniewski defending against Halaschuk. Halaschuk walks out. Short side save, dumped in front was Halaschuk. Here's another shot for the point. This one will be gloved, and wisely so, with the Predators on the prowl here. They've cut the deficit to one. They've got the crowd back in this hockey game.
Well, fans, give the gift of hockey this holiday season with the Blue Jackets Holiday Pick and Pack presented by Subway. Packs start as low as $79 and include two tickets to two games of your choice, a player autograph puck, and a $10 Subway gift card. Call 1-800-NHL-COLS or go to BlueJackets.com to get your holiday pack now.
From the draw, Tootin dumps it behind the net. Rick Nash will attempt to chop it out. Now steps away from Weber. And the puck is on to R.J. Umberger. Josi from Bouillon and Erat. A one-goal game as Nash looks for some open ice. Fires a shot high stick side. Puck off the back of the net. It's played by the Predators. Down is R.J. Umberger. Delayed offside, waved off. Broussard coming together there with Suter. And Erat circles back in his own zone, hands to Suter, on to Weber. The two of them, looking back at the last meeting in Columbus, Weber and Suter played 26 minutes plus in that hockey game in Columbus.
If you remember as well, how was the offense created? How about that slap shot by Weber?
Weber had five shots in that hockey game. Jackets, the words of Scott Arneal, played exceptional hockey for 58 minutes. Predators scored twice in the final 2 minutes to send it to overtime. Here, Jackets lead 5-4. Four of the five goals have come on the power play. Jeff Carter, a three-goal hat trick in the opening period. Johansson has the other two. Hillen turning away from McKenzie. Throws it up the far wing. Gets by Hornqvist. It'll be played by the Jackets. Clitson. It's on here to John Moore. Moore sends in behind the net. Unable to trap it there as Rene. Spalling can't get a stick on it. Clitson will. It's gloved and held by Rene. 4:09 left. Here in the second.
Doubleheader beginning with the Rams heading to Pittsburgh. Then, in America's Game of the Week, the Eagles hope to keep their playoff hopes alive as they battle the NFC East-leading Cowboys. Coverage begins Saturday with the Built for Tough NFL on Fox pregame show starting at noon Eastern.
Nashville has outshot the Jackets here in the second, 11-7. They've outscored them 3-1. Jackets leading 4-1 after one period of play, having outshot Nashville 15-10. Currently, Jackets have a slim one-shot advantage at 22-21. The faceoff will come to the right of Rene, and the draw won by Carter. Two. Sends it wide. Rene out of the net to play. Letestu unable to trap it behind the net. Nikitin will blast one. There's a backhanded attempt by Letestu, and a great pad save by Rene. Rene sticking out that big right pad and is able to turn Letestu aside.
Letestu looked like he thought he had a little bit more time than he did.
Nikitin, outlet pass sent to center. Carter, held up there by Bouillon, played off the wall by Nashville, and then quickly cleared the center. Crosby trying to tie up Erat. Fetter Tootin turning away from traffic. Up the middle, redirected by Dorsett, and up into the crowd. Let's take a look at that opportunity for Letestu right on the doorstep. Watch this stop by Rene.
Well, you get a chance, and he's on the backhand, and I think, again, he felt like he had a second, but how about Rene? Well, he as big as he is, he leaned forward, watched the right pad, and then again, Letestu just missing the inside post, but a better job by Rene.
Grant Clitson circles the net, protects that puck as three Predators convert. Moore. Bump. Gets it to Dorsett. Hillen is there. He'll sweep it ahead. Moore. Again, chipped it up. Linear board. Kalaschuk. Looks to walk to the net. Save Sanford. And he covers up as the Predators jam the net in front. Dorsett drops 2-2. 2-2 wants to go. And Sammy Paulson wisely steps between Dorsett and 2-2. But it was Derek Dorsett, who dropped 2-2 there, and they continue to talk.
Well, look at the work right now by the Nashville Predators. They put their nose to the grindstone, and they are starting to drive to that net. 2-2 is there. Smithson is there. Halaschuk, he started to walk out of the corner to create that offense, and they stayed right with it. And that's where the Jackets right now, Jeff. You're halfway through, or basically two-thirds of the way through this hockey game. You now have to come in, and you've got to match the want and the desire of this Nashville Predator hockey team. You're up a goal, and here before the end, you've got 3 minutes left in the second period. You've got to continue to play hard-nosed hockey and match exactly what Nashville's throwing at you.
Well, it's no secret. You knew that Barry Trotz would have more than a few words with his club at the conclusion of the first period, totally dominated by the Blue Jackets. And this hockey team And the coaching staff does not have quit in the vocabulary.
Now, the one thing you look down that bench of the Columbus Blue Jackets, they certainly know that they're in a ball game right now.
All rights to this broadcast are reserved, and any rebroadcast, recording, retransmission, or other use of the broadcast without the express written consent of the Columbus Blue Jackets is expressly prohibited. From the faceoff, played by the Jackets, the zone cleared by Wisniewski. Weber keeps it away from R.J. Umberger. In that matchup, Barry Trotz gets the last line change, and he has elected all night long to have Weber and Suter matched up against the Broussard Umberger Rick Nash trio. Off the netting, the puck gets stopped there. Hornquist not happy with that. He thought the puck was loose. And he'll get a faceoff. Once it gets caught on that netting, play whistle down. Now we've got Tepper's a little short.
That's what you like to see. Hornquist doing a lot of jawing. He had a chance tonight to be able to collect his ninth, and talked about the struggles that they have offensively. Hornquist coming into this game, one goal in the last 19, and certainly tonight it's on the board.
We're going to get coincidental minor penalties here. The officials do not want to lose control of this
Nashville
hockey
penalty
game.
Number 74, 2 minutes roughing.
So slashing and roughing minors, respectively. There's Kostitsyn and Derek Broussard for the Jackets. So with 2:18 left here in the second, we'll have 4-on-4 hockey as the respective coaches look on.
Well, you're coming into this game, Nashville Predators 20th in the league in faceoffs. The Jackets were 11th. The Jackets have been hovering around that 9, 10, 11 mark here for the entire year. Right now, 51% on the night.
Faceoff to Sanford's left. Camp on the edge of the goal crease. In fact, he's outside the paint here as he gets set for the draw, won by Paulson. Turton. Dancing away. Spalling. Puck turned over. It's played by Dorsett. Down the left wing and out to center. Dorsett backhands it by the defender. Rene retreats to that as Bouillon sweeps it off. Played by Josi, who scored the fourth and the last goal in this hockey game. As we now have less than 2 minutes to go here in the second period. A 5-4 Columbus lead. Josi fires, and that's deflected. Josi called up and playing in the absence of Kevin Klein.
Well, he's done a nice job. Again, this young man right out of Switzerland, played for the Olympic team back in 2010, two-time World Junior Championship, and in Milwaukee last year. How about 6 goals and 34 assists? 21 years old. Certainly have a bright future, and certainly showed a rocket that he had coming off of that right side on a beautiful pass by Bouillon.
What is it about this Nashville Hockey Club that for some reason they've had the market cornered in drafts of defensemen? They built their defense basically in 1 year with Suter and Weber and the rest of the crew.
Klein, yeah.
And they just continue to find outstanding young defensemen.
And they're, you know, second and third round picks as well, Jeff. It's not like they're taking the cream right off the top.
Well, that is certainly a testament to their scouting staff, the general manager, David Poile. Nash gets behind the defense, puck rolling on in. And, of course, Paul Fenton, the assistant general manager. Before that, Ray Shiro was here. They have done just a superb job drafting. Less than a minute to go. Shot right in and stopped by Sanford. Along with scouting goes development. And certainly, the Predators have done an excellent job in developing their young defense.
They follow that same suit with their coaches.
Here's a shot from the wing by Smith. Off the shoulder of Sanford. Ruck, the puck rolling on end. It's picked up there by Carter. He'll step to center. Tries to settle that puck down. It's swept away from him. Late in the period, that puck is rolling. Tootin finishing a check on Mike Fisher. Nikitin in front of his own net. Walking away. Head up, skates to the line, and then drills it the rest of the way. Final 10 of the second period. Predators throw it up the near boards. Hornquist with a feed that Broussard is able to pick up as he walks out of the box And the second period has come to an end. Predators with their first shot lead at 25-24. They outscore the Jackets 3-1 in the second, but it is Columbus that hold a one-goal lead. Jackets 5, Predators 4 after 40 minutes of play. PEP power play summary through 40 minutes of play, and the Jackets converting on 4 of 5 opportunities, 3 on the 5-minute major to McGrattan for the boarding call against Jared Bull. 9 shots for the Jackets on the power play tonight. Nashville 1-for-2 with 2 shots. And again, we should mention 2 delayed penalties were going to be called against the Jackets, and twice in that second period, why the Predators converted. And we have a 1-goal Columbus lead here in the early moments of period number 3.
Well, they've got to really pick things up now in this third period. We've been down this whole lane before, and the story is the same. But tonight, the Jackets have to change their own fortune.
Best period of hockey for the Predators has been these third periods in the month of December. A lot of that has to do with that 5-game winning streak. They've outscored the opposition in third period play here in the month of December, 13-8.
And the Jackets, they have given up 44 in the third period. They've only scored 23 for a difference of minus 21.
This next goal, the Jackets certainly are pressing for it here, will be huge.
This is where it all starts. You get into that offensive end, again, run your offense. Start to cycle a little bit. Force them to work.
Mark Mathot. Away from Suter. Kostitsyn, a centering pass. Knocked down in front there, and there's a high stick. And they're going to check this out.
Well, Hornquist, again, nice enough to be able to come back to make sure he was okay.
Wisniewski is rubbing the nose there.
And there's Kostitsyn again, just taking it to the net. His transition tried to go back the other way by Wisniewski. He gets that high stick by Hornquist. And the Jackets will have an opportunity right now to their 6th power play of the night. Jackets 8 power play goals now in the last 6 hockey games. And boy, this is huge.
1:19 the time on the Hornquist call. Jackets with 9 shots on the previous 5 power plays. They converted on 4. Carter, now crossbow up front. Tootin and Nikitin are on the points and offside. Unable to hold it at the line there was Tootin, who argues briefly, but to no avail.
Well, be at Nationwide Arena Tuesday, December the 27th, when the Jackets take on the Calgary Flames at 7 o'clock. Then again on New Year's Eve, they're going to host the Washington Capitals. Get your tickets now at BlueJackets.com. You've got to see it live.
Weber deals it back to Suter. Suter throws it up the middle. Spalling trying to get behind the Jackets defense. Steers it ahead. Reversing. Nashville play it. On to Carter. Sprints through and across the line. On to Vinny Prospel. Prospel back for two. Nikitin moving into position. Shot by Prospel goes off Nash in a leg. Played by the Jackets. A centering feed high off the glass. Prospel trying to settle it down. Played by the Predators. And tossed into Jackets territory.
I like the positioning, Jeff, of where Nash is right now. Down in front of the net. You've got Carter playing around the perimeter. You've got Prospel off the wall. Great to see number 61 in and around an area of the net where he can do something.
Ryan Johansson, a centering feed off the wing. Umberger! Johansson passes it behind the net. Umberger's got it. Broussard waits at that goal line. Jackets kick it free. Broussard will chop it behind. It's sent to the point, but not out. Good save at the line there. Good hustle by Lutestu. Here's Wisniewski. Gets it ahead. In the right circle. Save. Rene, and he'll hold on. 41 seconds remaining in the Hornquist penalty.
Well, Derek Broussard, a couple of assists tonight. Umberger as well. He's got a couple of assists. Good puck movement, but what I like is getting that shot away. Broussard wastes no time. As soon as Wisniewski lays it off into space, he gets the shot. You've got people down in front of the net. You never know. A little bounce out in front, and Umberger's there to put it away.
Carter back on the ice with Prospel and Nash. Nikitin and Tootin remain on the points. Carter wins the draw. Played by Weber, and he'll hammer it the length of the ice. 30 seconds left in the power play. Nikit, head up. Finds, or at least attempted to find, Prosper there. The active stick of Suter breaks it up, and it's over the glass and up into the crowd.
The Cavaliers open the regular season this Monday against the Toronto Raptors. Join us for a special one-hour Cavaliers Live, starting at 6 with Jeff Phelps and Campy Russell. Then join Fred McLeod and Austin Carr for the tip-off at 7. The Cavs and the Raptors tip off the season Monday night, starting at 6, here on Fox Sports Ohio.
Tootin finds Carter and neutralized. Right back to Fetter Tootin. 3 minutes plus gone here in the third as Nikitin sends it in. Final 10 seconds of the Hornqvist penalty. Tootin snaps across the line. Prosper looking for that return feed for Tootin. Edged out by Weber. Played by Suter. Hornqvist back on and off to the bench. Team's at full strength. This is Tootin across the line and a stick to side. Eric Dorsett tried to chip it out of the zone. Predators play it up high. A pass here for Blum. He'll throw it behind the net. And off on that far side, Grant Clitson. Outlet pass. Dorsett sends across the Nashville line. Blum hustles to it. I mentioned a product of California. Did you say John Blum is a direct result of hockey becoming a big-time sport in Southern California with the rival of Wayne Gretzky?
No question whatsoever. His father played at the University of Michigan. Had a chance to play pro in the South. He ends up moving to California. You can see the end result. This young man is going to be a heck of a hockey player. Beginning of the week, they sent he and Blake Jeffrey on back to Milwaukee to work on their confidence. And then with injuries and sickness, well, they got called right back up again. Blum, well, he was the product of the first goal given up the other night against the Washington Capitals as Ovechkin chipped one by him. And ended up scoring the first goal of the hockey game to give him a little momentum.
Yet another one of the young defensemen drafted by this organization that's made it to the National Hockey League. In fact, his first game was against the Blue Jackets in Columbus. First NHL game. This is Smithson. Poke checked away. Moved by McKenzie effectively out of the zone.
And that's what you like to see. Good to see McKenzie on the ice. Nice job defensively by number 24.
Nash being double shifted here. With Johansson and McKenzie as the puck played off the wall. Nash unable to get a stick on it. Bouillon's got it at center. Francois Bouillon sends ahead. Jackets play it. And it's Nash, right wing for RJ Umberger. A lot of slashing going. Some have been called, others have gone undetected.
Not many hits tonight. 9-8 hit totals tonight. And Nashville has the 9.
Two. Gets it ahead, backhands into the zone, quickly cleared, and it's Erat dishing it out. Leguan with a long shot that bounces in on Sanford, who turns it aside. Smith for Erat, drilled by Nash on the far boards. Erat fights through the check. Here's Suter, floats one in, glove through all the traffic, and held by Sanford.
We'll see the Blue Jackets take on the Calgary Flames Tuesday, December the 27th at 7 o'clock with the Tim Hortons Jackets Pack. Include games, you get a game ticket, $10 food and beverage voucher, a team hat, and more. All for just $30. Plus, the first 15,000 fans receive a Blue Jackets calendar presented by Subway. Get your tickets now at BlueJackets.com.
Face off to Sanford's right. Carter wins the draw away from Mike Fisher. Fisher, one of the premier faceoff men in the league. Carter with a big win, but Fisher looks for that puck on the right wing. Jackets unable to clear, forced here now to move it to the left wing boards, and Prosper will send it high and out. Puck rolling on in. This is Hornqvist. Threw it across the line. Hornqvist drops it for Fisher. Shot blocked in front of Sanford. Carter steps in front of his own net and then flips it between the two defenders for Nashville, and Josi hustling back. His goal, cutting the deficit late in the second period to one goal. And the Jackets will be called here for icing.
Well, we're going to bring the face off with the icing call. Come back down to the stick side of Sanford. Sanford right now has been tested, no question whatsoever. Very quickly in that second period, 17 shots on goal. He gave up three.
Then he Prostl to the line, kept in by Tutu, backhands it ahead. Jackets pressure, the puck's falling, gets it to Tutu, a centering feed. Down is Sanford, loose puck. Sanford just now retrieving the goal stick and slow to get up. There was a collision there right in the goal mouth. The Jackets able to keep it from crossing that line. Now Suter deals to Tutu. Back at the point. Weber, Suter, cross ice. Spalling, 2-2. Jackets defend and Carter will dish it off. And the zone finally cleared as Vermette sends it into Predators territory.
Well, the Jackets can't start running around. This is where, again, they've got to return to home plate. And they had a chance to work on it this week. After the game in St. Louis, they spent the entire day going through that end zone. It has to be better here in this third period.
Sanford sends it to Dorsett. Zone not cleared as Erat was able to keep it in. Long shift there for Tutu, unable to trap it on the far side. Blum steps up. Vermette defending. Sammy Paulson around the net for the right wing feed. Up high, Hillen. He drills it. Jackets block that. Paulson can't clear. Smith got a stick on it. Jackets walk it out. And Tutin deposits it back in Nashville territory.
12 and a half minutes to go, one-on-one, certainly vital. In your own zone, in the offensive zone, Jackets have to continue to grind.
Here come the Predators again. Leguan with an attempted pass that's knocked down. Here's two. Chipped ahead by Brassard out to center. Crowd trying to encourage these Predators who have come from a 4-1 first period deficit. Well, the Jackets now press on into the offensive zone. That spot out there by Rene, and he will hold on. And as we go to break, let's take a look at the scramble at the other end minutes ago as Sanford's able to keep it from crossing the line and covers up.
Only coach the Nashville Predators know, and Scott Arneil on the right. Both coaches agree that the division games, they are certainly entertaining. It's easy for a coach, and usually the players, when they come into games like this, they are pumped and they are ready to go. Certainly no difference tonight in this hockey game.
From the draw, Brassard, Umberger back at the point. Mathot rims it around the wall. It's cut off in the corner by the Predators. Umberger is there, can't make the play. Hornqvist gets it out of the zone. Stepping up here is Suter. And offside the call as Suter and Mathot come together.
Well, nice job by the Jackets, and I like to see that. Mathot getting up onto the play. Trying to take away that space in that offensive zone, and that's where the Jackets, you want to be aggressive. Let's take a look at it as they come across the line and see what they have. Defensive blue line, certainly a key. Go ahead and stop it right there, guys, because now you look at your D, you look at the opposition as they come across. Go ahead and let it roll. That's where you want to put the pressure on. Good use of the stick, and then the finish with the body. Good play right there by Mark Mathot.
Face off outside the zone. Smithson and Antoine Vermette. Smithson cleanly wins the draw, but it sails deep and back into Nashville territory. Weber. And a walk away from McKenzie. Keeps those feet moving. Jackets up high, unable to keep it in.
Is it not interesting to see Suter and Weber out against the Jackets' fourth line, or third line right now? Vermette, Dorsett.
Here's Weber. 2-2. 2-2 with a left wing feed. Smithson looks, fires, saves Sanford. Centered in front. This time Sanford's going to wisely hang on, and that'll give us an opportunity to take a look at tonight's Miller Lite Taste Greatness moment, and it's the first period hat trick by Jeff Carter.
Well, the first goal scored by Carter, it's an even strength goal. And look at that release. Vintage. That is Jeff Carter. Then a power play. Watch him come in after the fact. As Nash gets in front of the blue, he does a nice job. And then the same thing. Carter fights for his space. Three goals in period number one. Certainly a key for the Jackets tonight.
Tell you another key. The fact that Carter's first goal came 27 seconds after the power play goal that got the Predators the early 1-0 lead.
Well, I agree with you totally. That's something that we have not had a chance to see from this hockey team. A little resolve.
Here's Erat. Off the point, Bouillon. He's got a pretty good shot as well. That's why Bouillon, Erat looking to cycle out of the corner. A little more than 10 minutes remaining. Third period regulation time. Columbus 5, Nashville 4. Shots favor the Predators 31-27. Last time in here, Sanford with 27 saves in the 4-3 overtime win. Knocked down by Mark Mathot, a high stick, but played by Nashville, so play allowed to continue. Now Umberger steps up across the line, offside. Nash ahead on the left wing. Thus the offside call with 10:15 left.
Well, Rick Nash tonight, he has a couple of assists in this hockey game. And I mentioned previously, Jeff, they've had a little different movement in their power play. You get Carter back and healthy, he finds himself on one side. You get Nash down in front of the net. Vinny Prosbel will work the wall. Good to see number 61, where he's going to have an opportunity to use those great hands, and not far from each of the goaltenders that he will be facing here in the National Hockey League. Nash as well ranks in the top 25 in takeaways, ninth in shots on goal. Right now, points in 7 of his last 10 hockey games. That's what you want from your leadership group.
Predators will hustle out after this one, move on to Dallas, where they'll take on the Stars tomorrow night. Blue Jackets will enjoy a brief Christmas break before resuming play in Chicago on Monday night, a game you'll see right here on Fox Sports Ohio. McKenzie, trying to keep that puck moving. Gets it back to Dorsett, camped in front is Vermette. He'll hustle for it. Hillen defending, good steal there. Jackets have it, Vermette wipes it. Rene way out of the net. It'll be played on the left wing. McKenzie, Dorsett out of the corner. Dorsett walks the top of the circle. McKenzie was tied up in front by Spallin. Jackets. And a good deep forecheck there, and the Predators walk out.
Great shift by the Jackets.
Here on the wing, Tutu Sanders. Oh, a kick save and a beauty. And Sanford is slow to get up. Remember, he is coming back from back spasms. And he looks like he's in a little bit of difficulty.
He sure does, Jeff.
He's flexing that leg. He's also suffered from a groin injury earlier on this season. And there with an outstanding stop to keep the Jackets in front. Let's keep an eye on Sanford here. He's shaking it off. Carter off the boards. Fisher sends it up high to Suter. Shot sails wide of the net. Hornqvist to the point for Weber. Wide of the net. Suter steps up. Tootin defended. Fisher below that goal line. The long stick of Carter, but he can't clear. Save made by Sanford. That's off the blocker. Sanford trying to see through the traffic generated by the Predators in front of his net. And he just pointed to his back. The linesman, or actually that referee down low, came over and asked him if he was okay, and he pointed to his back, Bill.
Oh, boy.
He pointed to his back, and the official continues to talk to him. Sanford waves him off. Meantime, Brassard walks to the front of the net. R.J. Umberger. Puck played by the Predators. You've got to hand it to Sanford here. He is not 100%. He's just still flexing that back as play continues.
What I like to see, though, is that communication. That's what you have to have. You have an official on the ice, being able to call it, giving guys a little bit of communication between either coaches, in this case, the goaltender.
Puck thrown into the deep Nashville territory. Yossi. Sanford looks up at the clock. Less than 7.5 minutes left. Here, it's tipped away. Antoine Vermette across the line and drills it. This is gloved and held by Rene. So a well-deserved break now for Sanford, who's shaking it off. He continues to remain in the Jackets' net. Sanford is far from 100% here, but he's gutting it out. And I'll tell you what, how about our Ohio Health great save minutes ago?
Look at the speed coming across the line. 2-2, finding Wilson on that backside. But look at the save by Sanford. And then take a look what Sanford does as the official gets a chance to chat with him.
Now, this is what we were talking about. Well after, see him point to the back there? He's saying, I hurt my back, but the official had the wherewithal to come over and make sure he was okay. He would have stopped play had Sanford told him But that fact was bothering him. Then, during the commercial timeout, he was over-talking to Mike Vogt. And again, pointing to that back that kept him out of the lineup in St. Louis. But you can see even now that he is in a little bit of pain here, but he's gutting it out with 7 minutes and 3 seconds left.
And that's what I like about a referee like Wes McCauley. Wes McCauley played collegiate hockey, played a little pro, and then started on the ground floor of officiating. And he knows communication is so important. And to be able to go over to that goaltender, yeah, my back, but again, I'm fine, I can stay. If he didn't, you can bet that he would have been off the ice in a minute. You can see him starting to stretch, and you can see Mike Vogt an opportunity to chat a little bit as well. No worse the wear. This guy is a trooper.
Suter steps away from Vinny Prospel, hands it to Weber. His defensive line mate rims it around the wall and tosses it all the way back into Jackets territory. And Keaton back. It's icing against Nashville.
Well, shots on goal right now, 33-29. Sanford making 29 saves in this hockey game tonight. Back up, Steve Mason gets a chance to sit. As previously mentioned, no game tomorrow night. Usually Jackets on the 23rd are playing. First time in a lot of years. They're going to get a 3 days off.
There's Wisniewski at the line, trying to hold off Kostitsyn, who sends it in. Sanford down, just covers up.
Jackets right now 54% on that faceoff mark. With 6.5 minutes to go in the hockey game. This is certainly a key. You can see Sanford just trying to stay with it here right now. He's got to keep moving. He knows it. The more you stand still, the worse it gets. And the 32-year-old Sanford, now a record of 4-3-1 against the Nashville Predators overall. And tonight, he's played an outstanding hockey game. You look at some of those goals, there's not a whole lot Sanford could do on a couple of them.
Yossi beaten to the puck in the corner. Prospel handing it back to Carter. Back. Carter walks it up. Cycling. Here is Prospel. Defending is Bouillon. Vinny Prospel out there. Sammy Paulson, who deals to the point. There's a shot. It sails wide of the net. On the right wing. Outlet. Erak. Far side of the ice. A backhand pass for Erat. Steps through it across the line. Erat hands it off to Smith. Back to Erat, and he cannot convert. Mathot defending. 5:40 now left. Third period. Leg one behind the net. Here's McKenzie. Chops it ahead. Not out of the zone. Shot by Smith. Ricochets to the corner. Swept behind to the far side. Off the point. Suter. Blocked by Vermette. Throws it ahead here to Derek McKenzie. McKenzie into the corner. Out of the net comes Rene. Good work there. Pitching in along the wall is Dorsett. Now Vermette hustling ahead of Suter. The two slip and fall. Weber attempting to play it. There, my apologies, that is Fisher. Jersey 12, Weber standing in front of the net. Lead pass up the middle, Kostitsyn, and a good poke check there by Fedorchuk.
The Jackets D have got to continue to keep their feet moving in the neutral zone.
Weber with a wrist shot. That's high off the netting. The faceoff will come outside the zone. 4:43 left. 5-4, Jackets lead.
Gives a little idea on what's happened here tonight. The big key back in period number one, Brian McGrattan takes a major penalty as he just impaled Jared Bohl into the boards opposite of the Nashville bench. The Jackets able to capitalize. Three power play goals.
4:35 left as the Predators dump it deep. RJ Umberger waits for it on that half board. Fisher got a stick on it. Suter with a drive, and that missed the mark. Weber steps up. And the Jackets clear as Umberger sends it the length of the ice. This will be icing. No, it's waved off. No, it is. Well, one of the linesmen waved it off, and the other one blew the whistle. But they're going to come back.
Greg Kimmerle holds the Jackets from making any line change whatsoever. So Umberger will remain on the ice.
Mark Šuček will drop the puck, actually waved it off. But nonetheless, the faceoff comes in Jackets territory. Shot by Suter. Rebound down in Sanford, and a penalty upcoming. The Jackets are going to be called here, giving the Predators a power play.
16 Columbus got a minor penalty holding.
And a holding call to Brassard.
Well, let's take a look down in front of the net. You get a chance to see where Tootin is, and you can see where Brassard trying to take away as that puck became available. And this is a great view of that last penalty. Brassard, boy, I'll tell you what, I don't know about the hold. It was a nice job defensively in making sure that Sanford gets a chance to see that puck. But any way you look at it, third power play of the night for the Nashville Predators.
Nashville 1-for-2. And stepping in, Colin Wilson, after Leguan was tossed from the circle. Weber on that half court, swept to the corner. Tootin defended. Leguan waits at the goal line. It's up high for Suter. Suter right back to Leguan. Leguan looks off Wilson. One-timer Weber off the backboard. Sanford cannot control, and the Predators have tied it up. Off the backboard. The puck swept home. And this one is tied at 5. Colin Wilson.
Well, take a look. When that puck moves from Suter to Weber, you've got to be able to take care of that weapon. And then you get a chance to see Leguan find himself in an opening as it comes off the end boards. Nice work below the goal line to find Leguan. And he finds the back of the net to tie this game at 5.
I was about to say, Colin Wilson fished that puck away from the Jackets behind the net, setting up Leguan, who had to simply sweep the puck home, and we are tied at 5.
That's why this sixth-ranked power play is so lethal. You've got a guy like Weber and Suter quarterbacking. Suter the playmaker, Weber with the cannon. Anything can happen.
3.5 minutes left. Tied at 5. A wild night at Bridgestone Arena, to say the least. And this one off the backboard and the glass held by Rene.
6 power play goals between the two teams tonight and the 10 goals that have been scored. And there's still plenty of time on the clock with 3:19 to go. But the Jackets on the road. Yes, you play smart, but you've got to be able to come back and try to have a little resolve like they did in period number 1 when 26 seconds separated the first goal of the game. Fisher had his 7th. Carter collected his 8th.
Wilson and Weber draw the assists on a game-tying goal here by Leguan on the power play. Leguan's 9th and 3rd power play goal. Umberger wins the draw. Brassard sweeps it to the point. Mark Mathot looking. Far side of the ice. Nash will play it. Cycling out of the corner. That's Umberger. R.J. Umberger right back to Nash. Nash again with Suter chasing. Nash protects that puck. Nash, Suter follows. There's a shot deflected. Brassard was in front. Looks to the skies and says, how did I miss not getting a stick on that one?
Well, a good opportunity, and again, Nash creates it from below the goal line. And you watch Suter playing man-on-man, and all he does, he just tries to be able to take away his space. Tries to get a stick on it, and the Jackets have got a little overload. You've got Umberger, you've got Brassard down in front of Pecorine, but what an effort right there by the captain.
Francois Bouillon. Yossi waits. Bouillon will walk it out of the zone. Bouillon, head up, dumps deep into the Jackets' end of the ice. Sanford, deep in that goal crease. Pucks disappear. I think it's caught up in the Keaton's equipment somewhere. He's looking all over for it. And it falls out of his glove. Had no idea the puck was in his glove. And with 2:41 left, the faceoff in Jackets territory.
Well, there's a guy that's certainly been garnering a lot of ice time. How about 23 plus minutes, except for three games this year?
You look at all
there
of them.
There he is. He got it. He got it. He got it. And all of a sudden, it falls out of his glove.
There's Tootin defending against 2-2. Next one for Matt. Josie into the corner. Bouillon off backhand. Vermet knocks it down. Bouillon will work the other way. Colin Wilson on Jordan Tootin. Across the line. Jackets defend. Spalling tied up along the wall. Nikitin gets it. Puck stripped away from him. Predators along the wall. Look to send it to the point. Knocked down by Tootin. Weber able to keep it in for the open man. Suter moves in, fires, save made by Sanford. Jackets, Dorsett attempts to clear. Tutu's lost his stick. Able to retrieve it, and then heads off to the bench as Weber steps in and across the line. Centers it in front! And heading to the net was Spalling. It didn't miss by much. Wilson on for Fisher. Fisher works against Buffett. Hornqvist. Mathot again steps between the two Predators. It's Carter who moves it up the far boards, and the length of the ice, this one is icing. 1:19 left.
Well, there's a look at Scott Arneil. He knew what time of game he was going to be into tonight. Even when you're up 4-1, 1 point in the hockey game, you know that this team that you play against, they've got a little resolve. They did it once before, back in the Jackets building, up 3-1. With less than 2 minutes to go in that game, two quick goals, and then they win it in overtime. Right now in a 5-5 game, the faceoff will be opposite on the stick side of Curtis Sanford. And this is where the Jackets have to do and really anticipate, first of all, where the draw goes. If you win the draw, then you can set yourself up accordingly. But you know that the Nashville Predators, the one thing that they like to do, they like to pinch the defense. So if you do move the puck from strong side to weak side, you can expect the defensemen of the Nashville Predators to come down and basically come right down below the hash marks, and they'll force the front of the net.
If you've joined us late, the Jackets tonight have scored 4 power play goals. Franchise record on the road. Carter had a hat trick in the opening period of play. The Jackets have built up a 4-1 lead. But the Predators have come back. We're tied at 5 with a little more than a minute left in regulation. The last 2 games between these two teams have gone to overtime, with the visitors winning each. Nash with a shot, and that was waved at by Rene. He did not look all that confident, but was able to throw the glove out and hold on.
Well, I'll tell you what, the Jackets come off the bench, and when they did so, they come over with speed. Rick Nash, all upon himself, he takes it upon himself to get to the top of the circle, and then a nice quick shot. I think if he had it back, he probably would have went a little lower, but a nice job by Rick Nash. Big spark. Now you got a face off in that offensive zone.
Carter, Umberger, Nash, up front. Petter Tootin and Mark Mathot are on the points here. Carter unable to get a stick on it and swept into the zone. Well into the final minute. Mathot away from Spalling. Drilled into the boards. Loose puck. Tootin is there defending. And Mathot slow to get up and slow to get to the bench. He went awkwardly and fell on that far side. And the thought in some difficulty as we look at him on the bench. Nikitin bump. Up high, Weber can't keep it in. Final 20. Shea Weber dishes it off. Suter. Here's Erat, walks in, scores! 8.4 seconds left. And the Predators have the lead.
Martin Erat
One goal in 15 games coming into this. And watch the pass. Suter finds the defense, and they're standing still at that blue line. Certainly not good enough. And then you hope that maybe Sanford can make the save. What a move to go five hole. And Martin Erat, his seventh of the season. And with 8.4 seconds left, the Nashville Predators have stuck one in the coffin of the Jackets tonight.
Sanford's going to come out of the net. Jackets are going to take an extra attacker here. .4 left, and from the draw, Wisniewski sends it in. Suter off the wall. Final seconds. And the Nashville Predators come from a 4-1 first period deficit to score in the dying seconds of regulation and defeat the visiting Blue Jackets 6-5. Celebration by the Predators.
That's brutal.